What's happening? It's Darian, the mouth of the South Gray, and I have expressed my faith in my belief in the Carolina Panthers on numerous occasions. I've told you that I think they could be a playoff team this year, especially with that seventh spot. And I've spoke their praises with conviction. But right now, I'm not doing exactly a 180 on my belief in them, but I am doing a 180 on that playoff spot. I don't think they make it, and I'm going to tell you why on Point Blank Period.
You can sleep when you die, Point Blank Period.
And you know this, man!
A lot of what I'm saying has to do with this loss to the Falcons. And I don't mean that the Falcons, though their record may show this, are this Rudy Poutine that can never ever get anybody in Carolina should have never lost to, though Panther fans may say that. The quality of the team that they faced had nothing to do with my decision making and why I came to this conclusion. It's the fact that they just lost. It could have been to anybody. But this loss made them not be 4-4, but actually become 3-5. And that's an issue. Because I look at their remaining schedule, and I look at who they have in front of them in the playoff race, and I don't think it's going to happen. You got close losses to the Raiders, the Falcons, and the Bears. You could point to any one of those games in those last possessions and say, that really cost them a chance at the playoffs. But let me read off their remaining schedule. They got to go at Kansas City, to the Bucks. Play the Bucks, play the Lions, at the Vikings, Broncos, at Green Bay, play the Washington football team, and play the Saints. I don't think they're beating Kansas City. I don't think they're beating the Bucks, and I don't think they're beating Green Bay. I think I can feel pretty concrete in that belief that they're not going to beat them. And at 3-5, that puts them at 8-8 at the best. And I don't think that 8-8 makes the playoffs this year, even with that seventh spot. How I think it breaks up is like this. You're going to have the four divisional winners, obviously. Even the NFC least is going to get in there. If the NFC least couldn't get in there, maybe the Panthers would. But you have the four divisional winners, and I think you're going to have whoever the second place team in the NFC South is. I think they take the five spot. And whoever the 6-7 in the NFC will be between the NFC West team, maybe the Bears if they can hold on, even though they're an ugly 5-3 team. And then, well, the two NFC West teams, the Bears and then the Panthers. But unfortunately, they already lost to the Bears. And both of those NFC West teams, excluding San Francisco, because I don't think they're going to make it, already have five victories. The Panthers are already in a two-game deficit. But let's just go through the rest of the schedule. The Lions, no cakewalk. Matthew Stafford can play. The Broncos, no cakewalk. We just seen them come back on the Chargers. And then you look at the Vikings. And you look at the Washington football team. The Vikings have a run game that can run on anybody. Yes, we just seen them demolish the Green Bay Packers. But the Panthers, who I called to get an interior defensive lineman or a linebacker in free agency this year. Well, not free agency, but the trade deadline this year. They didn't do it. They did not go get that. They did not shore up the run defense. And I think that will be the Achilles heel of this defense, even with all the young talent. So I look at it. And I say, they can run down your throat. The Washington football team, they can rush the passer. And we've seen how Paradis and that interior defense, interior offensive line was jacking up and allowing the Falcons to just run the same A-gap blitz repeatedly and get in. That pass rush of the Washington football team is even better. And you look at the Saints, if they got a play week 17, I don't think the Panthers win. They could win. They could beat the Bucks too. But I don't think they win any of those four games if those teams got to play. Kansas City, Bucks, Green Bay, Saints. I think they lose all four of those games, would have put them at 7-9. That's going to be very tough. So it looked good for the Panthers coming in, but that schedule and the deficit they're already at with the other teams makes their playoff chances slim to none. Point blank, period.